Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, the market has recorded, I would say, a solid price increase for the last 24 hours because we know that the prices of the major cryptocurrencies have increased solidly. And now this is an additional, let's say, intraday price increase. Bitcoin has surpassed a couple of minutes ago, or half an hour ago, let's say, the psychological level of $35,000 per one digital coin. Ethereum is above the psychological level of $1,100 per one digital coin. And I would say that this is something great when we see the crypto market in the green zone. And I want to say that today I will analyze the next cryptocurrency if measured by my market cap. So I will conduct a detailed technical analysis. So we analyzed the price chart of Bitcoin yesterday and analyzed the price chart of Ethereum. Of course, I will omit Tether because we know that it's not worth analyzing the price chart of Tether. The next one is Litecoin. Litecoin has actually recently displaced XRP from the fourth position. So now it's turn to analyze the price chart of Litecoin. The current price, according to TradingView, is $161.79. And this is how the linear price chart looks like. So Litecoin has recorded a solid price increase for the last 12 months. So this is something great. Now let's switch to the candlestick chart. And of course, I will start from the monthly time frame. I will remove all those unnecessary elements from the price chart. And then we start. So this is the price chart. This is the monthly time frame. We have a sequence of bullish candlesticks, a nice bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs, what I consider as a nice or reliable bullish signal. However, I want to outline that we're at the very beginning of the month. So this candlestick, the last one for the month of January, may change significantly by the end of the month. So we have to keep an eye on the price chart. However, if we have something like this, this is a bullish signal. And I want to say that this formation of three bullish candlesticks with relatively, let's say, nice or big bodies, such sequence of bullish candlesticks is called three white soldiers. And of course, the last one may change by the end of the month. However, if we assume that we have this sequence, this candlestick formation at the end of the month, this will be the so-called formation three white soldiers. And this is a bullish formation indicating potential price increase. So I would be very happy if I see something like this or even something better than this at the end of the month. But this is nice, let's say, initial bullish signal in the monthly time frame, one of the most reliable time frames. Now let's switch to the weekly chart. This is actually the last part of the price chart. So what I want to say is, yes, we also have this sequence of mainly, or I would say, of bullish candlesticks with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. So this is a bullish signal. Of course, the last one, the last candlestick, is the so-called long leg dodge. So the upper shadow, the tall upper shadow, I would say, indicates some of the market participants are booking profits, so they're exiting the market. However, if the price drops, we see that the bulls pop up and they start to accumulate more Litecoins. So they start to buy Litecoins. That's why they don't let the bears or the sellers solidly, let's say, sink the price of Bitcoin and of Litecoin. And this is actually a candlestick called, once again, long leg dodge. And I would say it is a candlestick indicating price consolidation. And first of all, I want to mention that some traders, they view this candlestick as a potential trend reversal candlestick. However, I don't think that this is a bearish candlestick at the moment, because first of all, after this solid price increase, I think it's something normal to see some price consolidation. Moreover, the current local high has already surpassed the previous ones. And the current local low of this candlestick is significantly above the previous one. So we have this sequence of candlestick with ascending local lows and ascending local highs. As long as it holds, I would consider this candlestick just as consolidation, and I won't consider it as a trend reversal candlestick. And I would say that we're in a bearish, let's say, I would say that we're in a bullish market and we're not in a bearish market. In addition, I want to mention that if we have a look at the previous local high that formed in the summer of 2019, and I would switch to a linear chart because sometimes I prefer linear chart over over the candlestick chart because it reduces or it simply removes the volatility in the price chart. I would say that this local high is something like support for the price chart of Litecoin at the moment. So if we draw a horizontal line, it's something like, let's say, $130, $140 per one digital coin. So I would say that this is where the first most reliable support at the moment for the price chart of Litecoin is. Let's get back to the candlestick chart and let's switch to the shorter time frames. So, daily time frame. You know, fellas, we have an obvious price increase, and it is very difficult now to try to find some channels or wedges or some technical formations because the price is just increasing without any solid, let's say, pullbacks. And even I would say we have this acceleration of the price increase. That's why I won't try to figure out what kind of, let's say, technical patterns we have, because they are not that reliable at the moment in the daily time frame. We simply have a bullish market and the price is increasing. If we switch to the 4-hour chart, the situation is absolutely the same. We have this acceleration of the price increase. Of course, I would like to mention something useful when analyzing such kind of price charts. We can just switch to a linear chart in order to remove the volatility from the candlesticks, or actually from their upper and lower shadows. And if we have a look at the price chart, it's easy to see that we have the sequence of ascending local lows. So this is a local low, the next one. This is the next one, the third one, the fourth one, So I would say that we have this uptrend. The same holds for the local highs. This is the one, a local high, the next one at the almost similar level. Then we see that the next local high forms significantly above the previous ones. So it just indicates that the bulls are really very strong. And what I want to say is, yes, we have this sequence of ascending local lows and ascending local highs. So it's easy to conclude that we are in a bull market. And now, some additional important information I want to add. First of all, when we have this bullish market or uptrend, it doesn't mean that at any point I can just open my platform or buy somewhere crypto by clicking the buy button and I will make instantaneously or in a shorter profit. It's not that easy, even if we're in a bull market. If you don't have an appropriate money management and investing or trading strategy, yes, once again, it's not that easy without a strategy to profit even in a bull market if you are buying the crypto. Because imagine you buy the crypto and then a pullback happens and some people panic and they sell at the bottom and then the price rebounds and something is really wrong. What I want to say is, even if something like this happens, and even if the price drops by $30, let's say, or $40, this is a solid price pullback. For many people, this will be something unpleasant. I mean, for people who enter the market here, and if something like this happens, and they, in addition, use leverage, this is something catastrophic. So, however, this will be still a bull trend because we will have continuation of this ascending local lows and ascending local highs. And this will be a very nice bull trend, so very solid bull trend. And to make some losses or to lose your money by buying crypto in a bull trend, this is something to say ridiculous. That's why each and every person investing or buying some financial assets and etc. Has to to have the appropriate strategy. And that's why, fellas, be very careful and keep in mind all those, let's say, important things. So that's it for today. I wish you a very wonderful day. Good luck in the financial markets and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.